Charlene, how are you? Good?
I'm all right, darling.
All right, good, good. I just wanted to get your screen up. All right, well, so we are here to talk about IRL with Team Charlene. So tell me a little bit about that. In fact, before we go into that, can I just abuse some of my time?
Yeah.
How have you been during this pivot? This pivotal time in history that's affected us in so many different ways. I know family's been through, you know, a plethora of different things. So how have you been? I really wanted to start with that. How is Charlene White?
It's interesting because it's been such a tough year for so many of us, especially the first quarter of the year, I'd say. And I was on maternity leave at that point. So when family members were losing their lives to coronavirus and being hospitalised, and it was just an awful time. And then you compound that with everything that was happening with the Black Lives Matter movement and all the images of essentially Black people being lynched on video. It was hard. I think it would have been harder for me had I been in work during the height of it, but I think it helped for me being at home with the kids and being able to digest it in that way. But what was equally important was for me to be back in this environment to, you know, give a slightly different perspective when it came to talking about it and talking about ways in which we can reflect it on our coverage.
That brings us to IRL with Team Charlene. Talk to me about that. I saw on Twitter and social how happy you were to land this. I think I retweeted or liked or whatever, but I know this means a lot to you. So for those who don't know what's coming, explain a little bit about it.
Well, I think, you know, Joel, the likes of you and I, when it comes to talking about race within families, we have the race conversation pretty early on. So I think my parents first spoke to me about it when I was probably about 5 or 6. And then I first experienced it when I was 7. And there seemed to be a lot of instances that year where it seemed to happen. It was at school. It was when we were on holiday in Spain. And I remember being in a pool, you know, a water park thing, and a little boy refusing to be anywhere near me or even play with me because I was Black. You know, and all these things sort of, but your parents preempt that and talk to you about it and try to explain to you why people do that so that it's not such a shock to the system when it happens. And then you fast forward to this year when all of us have been having conversations regarding Black Lives Matter, and I've been talking to a lot of parents, and you get a lot of responses from parents, white parents, sort of saying, oh, I don't need to talk to my children about race. They just don't see race. They're that generation, aren't they? They just don't see race. And trying to explain to them, well, you can say that because you've never experienced it. Your child will never experience it, but that doesn't mean that it doesn't exist, and pretending that it doesn't exist isn't the answer either. So then I just suddenly thought, actually, perhaps what needs to happen here is a program that kids and their parents can sit down and watch, in a fun way, teach them about race and racism and the history, the science behind skin color, for example, so they can watch it in a really, you know, a fully packed kind of product, not that long, and then they can have discussions about it afterwards as a family, honestly about it as a family, rather than ignoring the situation, because ignoring the issue of racism doesn't suddenly make racism go away. It's the opposite. Mm.
6 to 10-year-olds, I guess a lot of parents will be wondering what shape and form that discussion takes place in. How do you begin to enlighten such innocent contributors to this world and future prime ministers and whatever? So talk about the forum and the format the show is going to take.
Yeah, well, we've had to look at it from a really fun perspective, because kids aren't going to watch anything on TV where they feel as though they're being lectured to. That's just not going to happen. So we wanted to do it in a really fun and engaging way and use as many elements as possible that you don't necessarily see on TV at the moment, but elements which are also shareable online. So that's where the music comes into it. We trawled, you know, Instagram, YouTube, all those platforms looking for incredible performers who are writing their own content, who are within that age demographic, who are writing their, and slightly above, writing their own content, performing their own content. We wanted them to perform for us. Where do you see kids performing their own stuff on telly? You just don't see that, do you? We also wanted to involve cartoons as well, because kids love colour. They love cartoons, and what better way to explain a serious topic than through cartoon, through colour, through characters? So that's why we wanted to use that element as well. And I know from my nieces and my nephews, giving them nuggets of information that they can come away with, facts that they can come away with and show off to their mates about, that yes, they know all about that. We wanted to make sure we involve that too. So we talk about the science of skin colour, so breaking it down in a really fun way with some great fun scientists. We've got a couple of young brothers who take us through this journey of where do we all come from? Where does the skin colour thing come from in a really fun way, so that kids can come away with those facts, so they know exactly why we are the colours that we are, and the shades that we are, and the plethora of shades that exist. You know, that's how you make it fun. And we've got this gorgeous, colourful studio. Anyone who watches me on the news know and see this top, I love a bit of colour. So anything that involved colour was always going to be about me. We've got yellows, we've got turquoise, we've got reds. We literally raided the ITV cupboard to get as much colour as possible on this set. And then we just sit and chat. We've got kids that have sent in questions. We've got kids that have talked about their own experiences. We've got kids who were on some of those Black Lives Matter marches talking about how it was for them. You know, it's just fun. And I think for people to assume that you can't tackle difficult topics with fun, with laughter, with colour, doesn't really know children at all.
How many episodes? I know when it's going out and we can enlighten our viewers on that later on, but how many episodes? How long is this going to be on
for? We've got the one, but it's in two different sections. So the shorter version has been simulcast on ITV and CITV on the 3rd of October. And then the full version, all the bells and whistles stuff and all the fun stuff will be on the longer version, which is on the ITV Hub. Because as we know, kids don't necessarily watch things as it's being aired. A lot of them like to look back on stuff when they're sat there on the iPad and just watch things in that way. So I'm envisaging that most kids and most adults actually will watch it via the ITV Hub.
Well, I guess my last question is how much of bringing this to life was about making sure that your contribution to the debate and the discussion envelope children, which I know you're passionate about, not only as a parent but just in general, but as opposed to this was actually missing from the whole discourse?
Yeah, it was missing. And I think a large chunk of my early years of being a journalist was spent as One Extra in Radio One, as you know, so breaking down stories for a young audience. You know, that's what my training was, and understanding how we can talk to kids about stories and engage them in stories. That was what I did for almost 10 years. And I think for me, my head is always looking at ways in which we can engage those audiences, because to forget those audiences runs the risk of them not necessarily engaging in current affairs or engaging in topical discussion. And they want to do that. Kids, I think, are probably even more opinionated now than when you or I were younger, because, you know, where else could we discuss things apart from sat in the playground? Now kids can discuss things with other kids from all over the world. So you arm them with the right information and then they can do that. And they perhaps don't feel like they're treading water in something, because you arm them with stuff and then they feel more confident to have discussions and to shout out things online as being wrong when they see it. So if they see a kid being bullied online because of the colour of their skin, if they're armed with the knowledge of what racism is, then they can identify that and they can stand up for that person and tell the bully that they're wrong. But if you don't educate them on that, how are they supposed to know that?